Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcad channel. Today I witnessed an accident. I saw the entire thing, and it was an interesting situation because it sort of highlighted some of my weaknesses in my preps, especially when it comes to emergency medical stuff. But as one EMT or as one volunteer firefighter said, that you can't always have everything that you need in every situation. You just gotta do your best, and he's absolutely right. Anyway, I was driving home and I saw this guy, his kid, his teenager on this ATV make a left-hand turn and just he drove out right in front of this police officer and actually hit the police officer, police officer's cruiser. And he just went out there and just hit the cruiser. The kid, probably, he wasn't looking in both directions. So anyway, he hits the police cruiser. He gets thrown right off of his ATV. And I pulled over immediately and I went to see if I can help. Officer was okay. He wanted to see if the kid was okay. The kid was just, oh, I'm sorry, and all this other stuff. But, you know, his arm was obviously broken. It's one of those situations where his arm was visibly broken. So I ran and got some ice and some water, although I didn't give him anything until the nurse said it was okay. I got some Gatorade. I didn't give him anything until they said it was okay. I had a tent in the back. And we used this to sort of prop up his legs so that his legs were higher than his heart. And they were a little bit concerned about internal injuries, and they were concerned. We happened to have a nurse around, and she was helping him out, and she was concerned that he may actually have some type of internal injuries, neck injuries. The kid was actually moving around. And let me tell you something. When a nurse tells you after an accident to stop moving your head, let them secure that C-spine, let them secure your neck, don't move your neck around, don't try to walk around. I mean, his arm was visibly broken. His other one may have been broken as well. Just do what the paramedics say. I had some bandages, some things that we were able to use. We're able to use this, the pads. One thing I didn't have was a splint. But we were able to use some of this other stuff I had around. That tape, that waterproof tape that I got from Dollar Tree, that was pretty useful as well. They actually used that for the splint to actually secure it. And, you know, he was all right. But, yeah, it's good to have extra supplies around. And if you can help people who are in an accident, do your best. You know, I just basically provided the supplies, some of the supplies, and a volunteer firefighter showed up quickly, and they had more supplies, thank goodness, and they had a splint. And, you know, I just got out of the way and just let people do their thing. And that's another important thing as well. Another lesson I got from this was that it took well over an hour for the ambulance to get there. I don't know if they were prioritizing, and I don't know if they had other things they had to worry about, but I'm sure they did. But it took a while, and at least an hour or so. The volunteer firefighter, fire department actually arrived pretty quickly, so that was pretty good. So if you live out in the sticks, understand that it may be a while before the ambulance gets to you. It's going to be a while before the police can get to you in the ambulance. So, you know, we're way out here. So if something happens, you want to have some preps. You can't prepare for everything. But anyway, they thank me for having some of the items. And I thank the firefighters for getting there really quickly. But now I do have a splint. And this is really important. Can actually secure a broken arm, a broken limb, especially a broken arm. So this is really cool. I'm gonna buy some more. I actually have some, but I had it in that black bag, and I couldn't find my black bag for some reason. That black bag actually had the splints. But anyway, I have some emergency items in here, but I don't have anything in here that a thief would actually want. Just medical supplies. But anyway, there's some basic stuff you can have in your vehicle in case, you know, something happens. If something more serious happens, something serious happens, you can respond, you can do something. So anyway, I stuck around and waited for the supervisor, the police officer supervisor, to arrive and gave my statement, written statement, oral statement, whatever. And you know, that's just what happened. So it's important to keep things like that in mind. So most important lessons: make sure you carry emergency supplies. Make sure you know what you have, how to use it, where to find it in your vehicle. And, you know, do your best to help someone and make sure you don't do any harm, of course. And when the professionals get there, get the heck out of the way. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.
Oh, my finger next to it.
Oh, my God. Are you kidding me? He doesn't look too different from the city rabbits that I'm used to. Why is he just standing there? I think he's waiting to see. He's waiting and seeing what I'm gonna do. That's what I think. This camera makes it look like I'm a lot further away, but I'm actually a lot closer. I don't know, I'm just opening up the gate, and I'm just looking at him, and he's looking at me. We're just both sitting here.